If you're writing a 2D game on mobile, chances are that you care a great deal about rendering performance. But one of your biggest perf problems could be coming from a weird combination of alpha blending, overdraw, and how you create your texture atlases. But let's start at the top. Modern 2D games are awash in awesome graphics to create the visuals for their scene. But when you start to break it down, you realize that drawing your environment is actually a complex dance involving drawing multiple layers of graphics. For example, the background layer, ground info, sprites, and finally UI data. And every now and again, though, we'll see some weird additional layers pop up that don't end up contributing to the final scene. In reality, these extra draws create a lot of wasted performance, which is a scarce resource on mobile platforms. There's really two ways to look at how you render your graphics in your scene. The first is back to front order and generally involves drawing geometry farther from your camera before geometry that's closer to your camera. The end result is the last drawn pixel with the closest distance to the camera. Front to back order, on the other hand, draws images closer to the camera first and then progressively gets further away. Although the rendering order of both of these techniques produces the same final pixel color, back to front produces 2x more work that doesn't contribute to the final scene, or as we prefer to call it, overdraw. The reason for the performance difference has to do with how modern graphics APIs work. You see, OpenGL ES and all of its desktop brethren support a mode called depth testing, which allows you to avoid processing any pixels that don't contribute to the final image. Here's how it works. When a pixel on the screen is updated with color information, we also store its depth from the camera. When the rasterizer attempts to draw another pixel at that location, we first test the depth of the incoming pixel against that of the existing pixel. If it's farther from the camera, then we discard it, saving cycles since we don't have to compute any of the color. Now, if the incoming pixel is closer to the camera, on the other hand, then we continue on, compute its color information, and write it back to the color buffer. Overdraw is a term used to describe how many times a pixel on the screen has been redrawn in a single frame. For example, drawing a large background image like this, and then drawing a box on top of it, another one on top of that, and then finally putting some font on top of that. When you turn on your profiler's overdraw mode, you can see the parts of your screen that have been processed the most times. If your screen is super red, like this one down here, then chances are you've got performance problems. Any work you do on a pixel that doesn't contribute to the final scene is wasted work. Now, for 2D games, alpha blending is the single biggest source of overdraw. Generally, a majority of the scene has to be rendered with alpha blending turned on because those textures use some geometry that have an alpha channel component in them. When you render your objects in your game with alpha turned on, you're forced to render your scene in back to front order. This is because during each draw, the alpha operation needs existing pixels in the color buffer to blend against, which increases the number of times a given pixel on the screen gets redrawn. The truth is, the order in which you draw your game geometry has a profound impact on the performance of your game. In an ideal world, what you want to do is render all of your opaque geometry in front to back order, which will reduce the amount of overdraw that occurs, while rendering all transparent geometry in back to front order, which we're forced to do anyway in order to get the look we're after. But this is easier said than done, trust me. I ran an analysis over 1,000 games from Google Play and found the majority of them are packing both transparent and opaque images into a single texture atlas. Typically, this is a bad idea. Texture atlasing software that's used to do this operation doesn't always export the type of per-image information that allows you to know what was originally transparent and what was originally opaque. The result is that you're forced to assume everything in your scene is transparent and render everything in front-to-back order, regardless of the performance problems involved. To fix this in your game, it's actually pretty simple. When creating your atlases, split your alpha and opaque objects into separate textures. This will allow you at runtime to sort geometry based on what type of texture it has before rendering them to the final scene. The new process will help reduce overdraw and will help make your scene render faster. Oh, and one more thing. Once you've separated your opaque textures into their own atlas, make sure that you properly compress them with GPU texture formats. ETC, PVR, and DXT are supported all by various levels of hardware and will reduce distribution and GPU residency sizes of your textures, which is something everybody loves, right? Anyway, the truth is that you shouldn't take alpha blending lightly. Besides giving you the look you're interested in, there's a load of performance issues you may not be aware of. So think twice, alpha once, and as always, remember, perf matters.